course, has been tamed to meet emission standards, but it can still take on high-performance competitors without working too hard. Yet, with all that power under the skin, the Challenger also demonstrates some smart thinking. Its V6, as well as the automatic version of the V8, can run on mid-grade fuel and even tolerate regular unleaded, if necessary. We found it was a joy to drive, even in city traffic, with a front-heavy steering and suspension setup. On the inside, drivers and passengers will find a design scheme that could be dubbed a throwback. The instrument dials are simple-to-read analog units, and the center stack houses a well-laid-out set of audio and climate controls. This is one pony car that actually has room for adults front and back, as well as some pretty good trunk space. One of the pleasant surprises was the better-than-expected level of fit and finish on the car. This is an area where Chrysler had been somewhat sloppy in the past. Even with the legacy of a troubled corporate structure behind it, the Challenger is an example of how to build a niche car, which just might be the future for Chrysler. This is Greg Morrison.